If the years up to 1914 mark the end of the old order, then the modern age, the age of cities, skyscrapers, motorised speed, started in 1918. Edgar Varèse emigrated from France to America, and he found his true new world in New York. The impact of the city transformed him into music's skyscraper mystic.
Today is an age of speed, synthesis, and dynamics. Consequently, we expect contemporary forms to reflect those qualities. I tell people I am not a musician. I work with rhythms, frequencies, and intensities. Tunes are merely the gossips in music.
One of Varèse's great gifts to the 20th century was his demonstration that percussion instruments could take on the whole substance of music just as successfully as any other section. Of course, percussion instruments form the foundation of a whole wealth of non-Western music through the ages. But in classical music, it was a real revolution. The Orchestra for Ionization consists entirely of percussion, and it's used with an astonishing ear for collage. It's also, until the end, made up entirely of unpitched sounds, so that even the main themes are purely rhythms, which are so used to being the skeleton beneath the flesh, but so unused to carrying the entire weight of music. But the sound that everybody always remembers from this music is the lonely city sound of the siren, which is not just something sinister, but is the only sustaining sound in the first part of the piece. In fact, it almost takes the place of melody. For centuries, music was guided by a strictly audible pulse, a reflection of clear social hierarchies as much as anything else. Simplistically, the blurring of social orders seemed to liberate the hierarchies of rhythm. The pulse was there, even if buffeted by the stormy weather of Romanticism. But by the end of Gustav Mahler's life, coincidentally, shortly before the birth of the Right, even if the pulse was still tethered, the rhythms above it were floating high in the stratosphere. This is the place where rhythm has moved away from the tangible, the physical, over to the metaphysical. Mahler was a great transitional figure between the 19th and the 20th century. And in fact, a whole swathe of the music of our century is unthinkable without him. The Abschied from the Song of the Earth, one of Mahler's late masterpieces, is like a message from the other side. It's a philosophical tract, searching for peace and a sense of the eternal in a time of conflict. In this, it's blood brother to another great transitional masterpiece, the slow movement of Beethoven's Ninth Symphony. By listening to both of them, we can see the way in which music was going to change. Beethoven's magnificent arching melody is underpinned by a steady pulse, like some giant clock or pendulum. In Das Lied von der Erde, Mahler somehow uses his own version of the same theme. And so, if you think of... refracted 100 years later, you might come up with... Mahler, using so many of even the same notes, is, in comparison, floating in outer space. The rhythm has become infinitely flexible, and it just approaches a kind of floating incoherence before returning straight to the heartbeat.